My goal for this video is to help you understand how to solve this circle question from the 2023 A-level math test. Let's have a look. We have x squared plus y squared minus 6x plus 10y plus k is equal to 0. This actually represents a circle because, let me give you guys a quick review. If we have a circle centered at h, k with radius r, then it has a general equation x minus h squared plus y minus k squared equals r squared. So our first goal is to put this into this form so we can see the center h and k. All right, so to do so, I'm going to keep x squared and then minus 6x together like this. Leave a space, continue with the plus y squared plus 10y, leave a space, but put the k to the other side. So we will get minus k. Okay, now we will have to complete a square for x and also for y, and this is how you do it. First, we have 1x squared already, so we can proceed by looking at the coefficient of x and take half of it. So already down here, half of negative 6, and then put this in a parentheses and then work that out, right? This and the square and then work this out. So inside here, we have negative 3, square that, we get positive 9. So we will work this out, and this is the number that we are going to add to both sides. Put a plus 9 here, and also put a plus 9 here. I call this number the magic number, because this number is so magical, it's going to make the first three terms a perfect square. You're going to see that, because we still have to work out the one for y. So same thing, 1y squared, and then here we have 10y, so we take half of 10, and then remember, put a parenthesis, square that, that is 5 inside, square that, we get 25. And you can see that I'm not writing really hard for the blue marker because it's about to run out of ink, but don't worry, plenty. Anyways, add the 25 here and add the 25 here. Now, ladies and gentlemen, this right here, we can factor it. We get x minus 3 times x minus 3. Another way to get the minus 3, it's actually from here, right? It's always the case. So x minus 3 squared. Continue with the plus, factor this, y plus 5, or just factor it the usual way, whichever way that you prefer. And then finally, on the right-hand side, it's just minus k, and then that's plus 34. Now, the center is what? Be careful. The center is that we will have to have what? Positive 3. Right, because this is x minus 3, and then the formula is x minus h, so the h is 3. It's kind of like do the opposite. If you see minus 3 here, the center is at positive 3. Comma, we see positive 5, so the center is actually with the y value here, negative 5. So that's the first part. The center is 3, comma, negative 5. Now, part B is a little bit trickier. Right here it says that we don't want the circle to cut or touch the x-axis, and our goal is to find out all the possible k value that will make it happen. So here's the deal. From earlier, we know the center is at 3, negative 5. So let's take a look at the quick picture. Let's say here is 3 and here is negative 5. So here's the center. Well, you can draw the circle like this, or maybe a little bigger, but of course the circle cannot be too big. Otherwise, it's going to touch the x-axis. So the biggest possible circle that you can draw is something like this. What's the condition though? Well, you just have to make sure that the radius, which is from here to here, this distance would be 5. And you have to make sure the radius is less than 5. So that's one condition. But in fact, there's another condition though, because you have to make sure that this right here turns out to be a circle. So another condition is that r has to be greater than 0. So that's like the tricky part right there. Now, what is r? Well, remember, this is the standard form of the circle. We have this equals r squared, right? So that means if you look at this part, that must be r squared. So I'll put this down. R squared must be equal to negative k plus 34. And then we can just take the square roots to both sides. Just the positive square root though, because r is the radius, it has to be positive. So r is just the positive square root of negative k plus 34. So now we just have to set up the inequality that r, which is square root of negative k plus 34, this has to be in between of 0 and 5. And then if we can solve this inequality, then we'll be done. So let's do it. And here's the deal. Because square root is an increasing function, you can really just square this, square this, square that, and maintain the inequality. This and that will cancel. So we will just have 0 squared, which is 0, and then this is negative k plus 34 less than 25. Then subtract 34 here, here, and also here. And again, you maintain the inequality. So this is negative 34 less than negative k less than negative 9. Now, lastly, we will have to divide everybody by negative 1. So we have 34. And then in the middle is k. And then here is 9. But since we're dividing by a negative number, so we will have to switch the inequality now. This becomes greater than like this, and this right here becomes greater than. And usually we like to have the smaller number going left, right? Because this is like saying k is in between of 9 and 34. So I'll just put down the answer is that k is in between of 9 and 34. 9 including the 9, 9 including the 34 though. So this right here will be the answer.